Good evening. Before we begin tonight's ceremony, I ask that you please rise and join me in honoring our nation with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. Welcome to Hampton Bay's High School Senior Awards Night. My name is Christopher Richard, and it's been my pleasure to serve as the secondary school principal during the 2007-2008 school year. I would like to begin by thanking some of the people that made this year a success. Thank you to the Board of Education for your support. Our academic, co-curricular, and athletic programs could not be a success without your dedication to the Hampton Bay school community. Thank you to our Superintendent of Schools, Joanne Lowenthal, for your leadership. Our Business Administrator, Mr. Luce, who takes care of our budget and everything else. The administrative team of Mr. Clemenson, Mr. de Blasio, Ms. Romano, Mr. Clark, and Mr. Walker for helping to create and support our educational programs. To our faculty and staff, you are the ones in the trenches doing the most difficult of all jobs, providing the children of Hampton Bays with a comprehensive education. A special thanks to the main office staff, and especially Mrs. Kling, for spending countless hours working with our scholarship benefactors in creating the programs for graduation and this evening. Mrs. Kling was behind stage. I could not have done all this without you. Thank you to our scholarship benefactors for supporting our graduates in their dreams of obtaining a college education. And finally, thank you to the parents of the class of 2008. It is the lessons that you have taught these exceptional young men and women that bring us here today. Tonight we will honor the accomplishments of our candidates for graduation by awarding local scholarships from our generous benefactors, whom you will have an opportunity to meet throughout the evening. In addition, the Hampton Bays faculty will have an opportunity to recognize the academic success of our students through departmental awards. And as you are about to see, we have a great deal to celebrate. But before we begin, I would like to share some important information that I'm very proud of. An impressive 46 members of the class of 2008 will be graduating with Regents Diplomas with the Advanced Designation. 15 of those students are receiving the Advanced Designation with honors. The class of 2008 was offered more than $600,000 in scholarship money from the colleges and universities in which they applied. The students of this class are members of an impressive 11 scholar-athlete teams, achieving collective averages of 90 or higher during their respective seasons. And these students will be attending some of the finest colleges and universities in the nation this fall, including Tulane, the University of Michigan, Boston University, Stonehill, SUNY Stony Brook, and California Polytechnic State University. Our scholarship committee and benefactors have difficult decisions to make when selecting students from this class to receive awards. Transcripts, formal applications submitted by our students, essays, and sometimes interviews were considered in the selection process. In the end, I simply wish there were more to give, as the students here this evening have earned it. Our first presentation of the evening will be award acknowledgments for those students who have already received awards during this past year, or who will be receiving scholarships this summer. As I call your name, please stand by your seat. The following students will be presented with awards from the Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 5350 at their July meeting. Please stand when I call your name. Nicole Havens. Joseph Simmons. Samantha Prince. David Spears and Kelly Connery. Please be seated. Jameson Metz was the recipient of the University of Rochester Xerox Award for Innovation and Information Technology. Jameson? Brianne Frame was the recipient of the Daughters of the American Revolution and Citizen Award. the RPI Medal Award and the Boston Honorary Faculty Award. Mallory Kuklinski was the recipient of the University of Rochester Young Leaders Award. And Kate Von Malbach was awarded the New York State Leaders of Tomorrow Scholarship. Okay, just one last round of applause for these students and this. Okay, I'm going to begin the next portion of this program by inviting the scholarship benefactors and those members of the faculty and staff who are going to be presenting awards and scholarships this evening. The first scholarship is going to be the Kiwanis Club K-Kids Award, and I'd like to invite Mrs. Moran and the K-Kids up to the podium at this time.
Hi everybody. My name is Mrs. Moran. I'm an elementary school teacher and a K-Kid advisor. I'd like to introduce Lori Schneider from Southampton Kiwanis Club, who joined us tonight. And we have some of our officers who are going to do the presenting and tell you a little bit about the club.
Hi, my name is Matt. I am the president in the K-Kids Club for 3rd and 4th grade. We are a community service club that is sponsored by the Southampton Kiwanis Club and Kiwanis International. Here at the high school, the club is called Key Club, and next year the Builders Club will start in the middle school. The purpose of these clubs is to provide students opportunities for working together in service to their school community.
I'm the Sergeant at Arms of 3rd and 4th grade K-Kids Club. The club came about 5 years ago when a student named Nick Moran went to a Hopi Leadership Conference. There he learned about the club and returned to start a new one. Since then, both clubs have conducted numerous community service projects and helped hundreds of people. Just this year, along with the K-Kids Club, raised money for the Make-A-Wish Foundation, the American Cancer Society, the Olivia Allen Campaign, the John Easton Foundation for Sick Children on Long Island, along with many other activities and others.
Hi, my name is Jake. I am the Vice President of the 3rd and 4th grade K-Kids Club. The members of the K-Kids Club participated in making tissue paper flowers for a Mother's Day flower sale. The members ran the sale for 3 days and raised $500 for our annual K-Kids Scholarship Award. Tonight we will be presenting this award to a graduating senior who has been an active member of the Key Club since 2005. The student also has demonstration at academic excellence with a weighted average of 101.23. When asked where her greatest sense of accomplishments come from, she responded, helping others. There's nothing I would rather be doing. That really says it all. Club is proud to present Mallory Kuklinski with the K-Kids Scholarship Award. Congratulations and good luck to everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Moran and the Gay Kids. And now to present the Kiwanis Club Scholarship and the Hampton Bays Little League Brian Tucker Memorial Award, Drew Walker. Good evening. On behalf of the Kiwanis Club, it is my pleasure to present their scholarship award, the Kiwanis Club Scholarship. Each year, the Southampton Kiwanis awards a $4,800 scholarship to a deserving graduate. This award is presented to a student who is active in the community service, has excelled in scholastic achievement, and has displayed leadership qualities. This year's Kiwanis Scholarship winner is Mallory Kuklinski. The second award that I'm presenting tonight is the Hampton Bays Little League Brian Tucker Memorial Award. The Brian Tucker Award is presented in memory of Brian, who was a member of the Hampton Bays Little League at the time of his death. This award is presented to an outstanding baseball player in their senior class. This year's winner is Rich Pecoraro. Congratulations to each of these students. Thank you, Mr. Warren. At this time, I would like to introduce Mr. Warren Booth, who will be presenting the Arthur J. Jones Scholarship Award.
Good evening. First of all, congratulations to the whole class of 2008. We're here representing the Arthur J. Scholarship Foundation, and this foundation is a big part of a lot of people who are sitting out in the audience right now, the big contributors to this. So without the contribution from everybody in the audience, we couldn't be up here today. On September 11, 2001, the world in which we live changed in a matter of minutes. As a result of the tragic events that transpired that day, it is difficult, if not impossible, to find someone that has not been affected in some way. Putting aside the challenges alluded to earlier, the inquiries, both private and governmental, the chilling fact is a simple one. Thousands of innocent people went to work that day just like any other and would never return home. Arthur Jones was one of those people. This scholarship was conceived by a group of friends who felt the need to do something, anything they could to keep Art's memory in their hearts and minds. While it may never pass as where we don't think of him, the function of the scholarship makes the memory tangible. With that in mind, the backbone of the scholarship is a combination of both academics and athletics. Art was a 1982 graduate of Hampton Bays High School. He was a gifted athlete and student with an uncanny ability to befriend anyone he encountered. These characteristics, along with the support of the communities in which he lived, his diligent work ethic, and the all-around person this enabled him to be, have become the criteria upon which we select the recipients of our scholarship. Our goal is for the Arthur Jones III Scholarship to become the largest private scholarship at our alma mater, so that the future candidates will recognize the importance of this award for the reasons other than financial. Having said that, we are honored to announce that this year's recipient of the Artie Jones III Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $5,000 each are Kate Von Knobloch and Lyle Chantel. We wish you a happy success and a very good one. We hope you will be back and of course, the congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you very much. At this time, I would like to invite Mr. Nick Lombardi from the Handovers Post, number 924 American Legion, to present their awards.
Simmons Memorial Award goes to James Fuchs. And the runner is Jason Call.
Thank you.
next award this evening are the Thespian Society Awards. And here to give these awards for Ms. Dougherty is Mr. Duolio. Good evening. Unfortunately, Ms. Dougherty couldn't make it, so she has to file at 7 for her. But before I give out this award, I do want to say my first year as a counselor, I started here, was their first year in ninth grade, actually. So you guys partying and going on, I truly really miss you guys. We've been through a lot of years, and I feel like you've blinked our eyes, and now you're sitting on stage about to receive these awards, and tomorrow you're going to walk across the stage getting your diplomas. I could not be more proud of you guys. Okay, I'm proud to present the following Thespian Society Awards to, well, before I say their names, if anyone has ever been to any of the plays that we have here at the school, these two names are not going to be any shock. They're fantastic actors, and I really wish them all the success in the world once they finish here. That's Lexi Shepherd and Adam Fromm. Mr. and Mrs. Topless to the podium to present the Senior High School Student Council Service Awards.
Hello, everyone. We are here to present the Student Council Service Awards. These awards are presented each year to these students who are active members of the Student Council and have displayed extraordinary service. This year's recipients are President Mallory Kuklinski and Vice President Kelly Conley. Congratulations, ladies. You will be missed next year. Thank you for all your hard work. Thank you.
Our next awards this evening are the Social Studies Department Awards. And before I call up our presenter, who is Mrs. Frances Stefanik, I just want to say something very briefly. Mrs. Stefanik will be leaving us at the end of this year. She'll be retiring after many faithful years of service in the Hampton Bay School District. She is absolutely one of the best master teachers and one of the best AP European history teachers I've ever encountered in my career. So I would like to say, Mrs. Stefanik, thank you, and you'll be missed.
Stephanie Carlin, and Laura Jimenez.
This $2,000 scholarship is awarded to two graduating seniors, $1,000 each, who plan to pursue a career in biology, marine science, or in the field of environmental conservation. This year's winners are Brianne Frain and Cindy Dawn. Seafood restaurant. This $1,000 scholarship is given to a student who plans to continue their education and pursue a career in the culinary arts. The winner is Chris Randolph. Service Award, the Mark Sinclair Foundation Scholarship Awards, and the Vincent Squadron Memorial Scholarship, which will be presented by Mr. De Blasio. speech is this time. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm proud to present the 2008 County Executive Public Service Award to Kate Von Auerbach. Scholarship Awards. The Mark Sinclair Foundation is a local organization founded in memory of Mark C. Sinclair, a former graduate of Hampton Base High School, who succumbed to cancer in 1996 at the age of 42. To honor his memory, this foundation was created for the betterment of youth of the town of Southampton. This year, we are pleased to honor both a male and female graduate who have demonstrated community pride. Congratulations to Lauren Sullivan and Camp Bellman. Officer Vincent Spartan. Students are descendants of law enforcement officers and are chosen based on academic achievements and their wish to pursue a career in social studies or political science. Congratulations to Kelly Fountain.
Outstanding achievements. Corinne McMahon.
Mark Mulet.
Good evening. The definition of volunteer is to give oneself freely to a common cause. The common cause for the fire department is a sense of community, providing safety to our neighbors of Hampton Bays. The two individuals receiving awards tonight have shown the same common cause in their sense of community. On behalf of the chiefs, officers, and men of the Hampton Bays Fire Department, it is both my honor and privilege to present the first award to Anna Carino.
Thomas G. Maloney.
Lieutenant Solo. Our next award this evening is the Sergeant William Billy Wilson NYPD Memorial Scholarship. And it's to be presented by Ms. Kathy Young.
Good evening. I am pleased to present the Sergeant William Billy Wilson NYPD Memorial Scholarship. This award was created to honor the memory of retired Sergeant Billy William Wilson and his love and selfless dedication to law enforcement and the East End community. It is presented to a graduate who plans to pursue a degree or career in criminal justice or law enforcement. This year's winner is Robert Junker. Is on behalf of the Hampton Bay Civil Service Association. I am pleased to present our CSEA award to Brandon Allen,
Masons, and to present this evening is Mr. Singh.
Hi, good evening. Congratulations to the class of 2008. My name is Boise Singh, and I'm a past master of Bolton Lodge of West Hampton. I'll tell you guys anything you need to know about Masons. Those guys don't want to tell you, but I can. I'm here to present the Thomas Sinnickson Memorial Award, and this award goes to Jessica Hamelsbach. Congratulations again to all the students, and please do me a big favor. Be safe.
Thank you, Mr. Singh. At this time, I would like to invite Mr. David Krantz and Samantha Krantz to the podium to present the Pamela L. Krantz Memorial Scholarship.
Superintendent Joe Lowenthal, school board members, faculty, parents, friends, especially the Hampton Bay class of 2008. I am here tonight to present the second annual Pamela L. Krantz Memorial Scholarship Award. And I'm giving this in memory and honor of my wife Pam. In June 2006, Pam came home from work early, which is very uncharacteristic of her. I thought there might be something a little more serious than just not feeling good. She was showing signs of a possible stroke. Immediately, I took her to the hospital, and my suspicions were confirmed. She, in fact, did have a minor stroke. Further tests showed something else was also not right. She was diagnosed with stage 3B lung cancer. It was the worst possible news the family could hear. And so started a journey no one wants to take. We started using words such as cures, hope, faith, and believe. Then came words like clinical trials, prayers, miracles, and then quality of life. As strong as courageous as Pam was, the cancer prevailed and took her from us early in the morning, February 19, 2007. If you knew Pam, you would know absolutely and positively the main focus and love of her life was children. She was an aide at the elementary school, chaperoned field trips whenever she could, and never, ever missed an event, game, or a chance to be part of our kids' lives. Our children, Chris, Becky, and Sammy, are proof of the values that Pam believed in. Her love for her own children radiated to others. She ran an affordable daycare that was never about the money. It was always about the kids. She loved the beach. She may be best remembered down at Quantico Beach leading the way with her cackling children following behind her in the sand. I'm sure there are a few out there right now that consider Pam one of her moms. Even some of the younger teachers here was experienced with her as a mom. She always made sure they had the best and got their fair share. Pam attended school board meetings regularly, consistently asked the tough questions, and remained persistent until she got the answers. With a desire to be part of the solution, she was elected to the school board in 1998 to June 2004, including terms as vice president and president. I asked the administration if I could set up a scholarship award in honor of my wife, Pam, to recognize a two-letter student-athlete having at least an 85 grade point average, actively involved in the community, and as Pam would want it, to stand up and speak up for what she believed in, and to do so with dignity and pride. So without further ado, this year's award goes to someone that is very special and near and dear to Pam and myself. So please join me in congratulating the recipient of the 2008 Pamela L. Krantz Memorial Scholarship Award, Stephanie Martinez. Very skilled in public speaking. Thank you, John Maloney, so sit back and relax. On August 24th this year, there's going to be a fundraiser that's held every year, and it's going to be a 3-mile walk race around Lake Agawam, and it's for lung cancer research. And I can give you the boring statistics that are very real, but I'm asking each and every one of you to join me and put together a team Pam to raise money for lung cancer research. There are flyers out in the hallway that have my email address and all the information you need. 172,000 Americans will get lung cancer this year, and 163,000 of them will die in a year. And I think it's very important that each and every one of you remember that statistic. Please join me. Last year, Uncle Paul and myself ran the race by ourselves, and we're running it for you last year. This year, I want everybody to run a couple of laps. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Krantz.
Thank you, Steve.
Our next award this evening will be presented by Mrs. Price for the Math Department and the King's Government Memorial Scholarship. I'm sorry, and Ms. Disgrove.
Davis and Paul Bonner.
Good evening. Congratulations to all the members of class of 2008. It's been an amazing year academically and athletically. I will miss watching you guys on the athletic field. To continue with the math awards, I'd like to present to the members of the senior high math team, so my pointy name just come up. Sabina, Ben, Neil, Courtney, Bree, Nelson, Lewis, Blake, Michelle, Mallory, Jameson, Nero, Brandon, John, Lauren, and Andre. Brianna's playing score, I believe, top amount of points for our team. We compete against Southampton, Riverhead, and West Hampton in meets for the year, and she scored 10 points for our team, so she has the first place award. Thank you for your participation. You made this respectable reset. You're not old, you get another award. It's okay. Some of you will come back. We also compete in a national math facts competition, the pre-calc and the calc classes take contests 4 times a year, and those scores are recorded and sent in electronically, and they award a first, second, and third place for our school. And those awards go to first place, Brianna, second place, Nelson, and third place, James Hughes. I have the pleasure to present the Outstanding Achievement Award for the pre-calc class, which goes to Tommy Maloney and Andre Lombardo. We offered this year for the first time in 4 years, we offered two AP calculus classes. We had the traditional Calc AB and the Outstanding Achievement Award in that class, Calc AB, goes to Lewis and John. And finally, for math, as I said, this is the first time in 4 years we offered the students the opportunity to take Calc BC. What that means is that they have to take an additional period of calculus, additional homework, additional tests, from January until May. But they set for the Calc BC exam in May, and based on the score that they get on that exam, they could and probably will get 8 credits of college math. For their local schools. So congratulations to both of them, Nelson and Bria. that's it for the math, but I do, as Mr. Richard said, I have one award. Took it out. During the fall of her 10th grade, Katie Spellman was diagnosed with leukemia and began home tutoring while juggling the demands of her treatment. I witnessed firsthand Katie's remarkable ability to meet problems head on and address specific issues appropriately and effectively. She courageously weathered the challenges of long trips to and from the hospital, hospital stays, and disappointments when her physical conditions made what others take for granted impossible. Katie's determination to stay in contact with friends and school activities was evident as she found the time to spend long hours working on homecoming and turkey trot. Her enthusiasm for cheerleading made her an excellent role model for the young girls she guided with encouragement and positive feedback in summer clinics. When she returned to our school community for her senior year, she resumed her commitment to chorus, using her gifted voice to bring joy to others. Katie taught me as much about life, its challenges, and the optimistic approach one should face each new day with as I taught her. Her sensitivity to others was inspiring. When newly diagnosed patients needed a comforting friend or peer, she eagerly spent time reassuring them that they could fight their personal obstacles and still stay connected to the life that they knew and would resume. She did. The Hampton-based community lost a very precious young lady when Katie passed away in April. It is with tears and honor that on behalf of the Hampton Bay Lions Club, I present the Katie Spellman Memorial Scholarship to Diana Lepen. Thank you. Good luck to all the graduates.
Mrs. Price and Mr. Israel. Okay, at this time I would like to bring Mr. Glazier back to the podium, who will be presenting the Hampton Bays Lions Club Scholarship, the Lioness Club Scholarship of the Hamptons, and the R Squared Excellence in Science Scholarship.
On behalf of the Hampton Bays Lions Club, I am proud to present the scholarship to Celia Tarpey and Sammy Francis.
Brandon McQueen.
Seven drum majors this year, four lettuce in the St. Patrick's Day Parade, and three lettuce in the Memorial Day Parade. They were able to keep the marching band in step and on cue and excited throughout each of these parades. We would like to recognize these outstanding leaders for their enthusiasm and dedication to the band. They are Adam Frank, Stephanie Carlin, Jameson Metz, Lexi Shepherd, Serena Lee, Chris Carlin, and Natalie Vincent.
Thank you. John Phillips Sousa Band Award recognizes outstanding achievement in interesting instrument and music for singularity in loyalty and cooperation, and for displaying those high qualities of conduct that school instrumental music requires. This year's recipient has been accepted to Camilla Scamia. New York's Miss Gang, okay. And all state this year. He is the heart of the band and an inspiration to us all. I'm proud to present this year's award to Adam Frank. Outstanding achievement in instrumental music. This year's recipient kept the tenor sax section in order, and we could always depend on her for anything. She has always believed in herself, her section, the band, and Miss Halsey, and we are proud to present the Patrick Gilmore Band Award to Krista Robin.
Thank you.
At this time, I would like to invite Mrs. Cooper from the Hampton Bays Performing Arts Parents Association to the podium to present their scholarship awards. Okay. Maybe Mrs. Cooper's not here this evening, so they can stay. Okay. Good evening. On behalf of the Hampton Bays Performing Arts Parents Association, I'm pleased to present the winners and the runners-up of this year's Pop-Up Music Awards. The winners are Adam Frank and Stephanie Collins. With our doctorate awards, and the recipients of the $250 scholarships are Serena Booth and Alexander Shepard. Clemenson back to the podium to present the Congressional Merit Award, the New York State Comptroller Academic Excellence Award, and the New York State Office of the Attorney General CCC Awards.
The Congressional Certificate of Merit is given to a student who has demonstrated outstanding citizenship and academic excellence. The Congressional Certificate of Merit goes this year to Brianne Frank. Comptroller's Office acknowledges those students in New York State who have achieved academic excellence and shown the potential for leadership through involvement in activities that improve our community. This year, Danielle Rouge has been selected to receive this award. Congratulations. State of New York Office of the Attorney General CCC Award. Two graduating seniors received the CCC Award, which recognizes character, courage, and commitment of New York's hardworking students. The 2008 CCC winners this year are Mallory Kuklinski and Diana McKenna.
This evening is the New York State Education Department Academic Excellence Awards. The New York State Board of Regents awards one $1,500 scholarship and three $500 scholarships to those students who have achieved outstanding academic accomplishments and plan to pursue a higher education at a state university. This year's $1,500 winner is Daniel Rouge. $500 recipients are Stephanie Carlin, Andres Landano, and George Perez. Griffin to present the Hampton Bays Teachers Association Awards, followed by the English Department Awards.
Hi guys, congratulations to all of you. I will really miss you. Good evening. As chairperson of the Hampton Bays Teachers Association Scholarship Committee, I am pleased to present our scholarship awards. the Hampton Bays Teachers Association Memorial Award. The $1,000 award is given to honor the memory of deceased HBTA members who served our students and our community so well. This award is given to a student who strives to reach their full educational potential. And this time, the award goes to James Hughes. Dedication in pursuing a career in the field of education. And this year's winner is Samantha Grant. William Kelly Field of Business Award. This award of $1,000 is presented to a student who has excelled in business and wishes to pursue a career in this field. Congratulations to Laura Jimenez. This award of $1,000 is being presented to a student who has demonstrated a dedication to pursuing a health-related career. And this year's winner is Cindy Tarkin. Okay, next I would like to present the awards in the field of English, English Department Awards. The first award is for Outstanding Achievement in English 12, and the awards go to Kelly Conley and Jesse Himmelsbeck. The next award is for Outstanding Achievement in AP English Literature. And these awards go to Brianna Frame and Gina Abigail. Yearbook advisor, and I usually give out two awards to my outstanding members of the editorial staff. But this year, my senior editorial staff was so spectacular that there is no way that I couldn't honor all of the editors for this year's book. So first of all, the co-editors, Kenzie Loney and Kelly Conley. Business editor, Nelson Garrow. The next award I'm being asked to present by Ms. Collahan, the advisor for Abraxas Literary Magazine, who was unable to be here tonight. I would like to present in her name the following award to a student who has made outstanding contributions to Abraxas as an artist, photographer, and writer over the past 5 years. That student is Anna Frank. The Abraxas Senior Achievement Award. This year, Abraxas, our school literary art magazine, would like to recognize this person for his outstanding contribution and leadership to the magazine for the past 2 years, and this year as senior co-editor. And that would be Michael Lloyd. We know that Michael will continue to do his very best in his future endeavors at college and in years beyond. So here's a token of the appreciation of the Abraxas, a little something to help you purchase all those books. Thank you very much, and congratulations
to all of you. Good evening. It is my distinct pleasure to give this award for outstanding contributions to the school newspaper. The recipient of this award is a remarkable young woman who is wise beyond her years. Over the past year, she has written thought-provoking articles on controversial topics such as the war in Iraq, women's abortion rights, and the erosion of American civil liberties. She is a conspiracy theorist to the core. I'm proud of it. I know that we will hear her name on the radio someday, but I hope that we will also see her name in the New York Times or the Washington Post. She's that good. If I have been saying it, Stephanie Carlin will be the world's first rock star journalist.
Congratulations, class of 2008. On behalf of the Science Department, I'm pleased to present the following awards. The following students have received outstanding achievement awards for AP Biology: Nelson Garrow and Daniel Bouge. Outstanding academic achievement awards are Danielle Rouge and Kareem McMahon. They created a wonderful mural for us to enjoy for many, many years. Achievement in physics. These two awards go to Andres Londano and Brianna Frame.
Spanish language that much easier. Thank you. First, Okay, I'm proud to present the following foreign language awards. For academic achievement in AP Spanish language, the certificates go to Blake Missler and Gina Alexandra. And for the highest average in AP Spanish language of 4 years, actually, the certificate goes to Brianna. Good evening, everyone, and congratulations to the class. I'm proud to present the following ESL awards for their outstanding achievement and effort. This year's certificates go to Jessica Bentencourt Valladares and Jenny Bueno. I don't know if they're here tonight, but I do try to call them. But buena suerte, good luck to everyone, and congratulations again. See you tomorrow.
Thank you, Ms. Gilman. At this time, I would like to invite Mr. Walker back to the podium to present the Hampton Bays Booster Club Scholarships and Doc Fowler Memorial Awards and the New York State Suffolk Awards. Ago, we had an end of the year athletic awards ceremony, which was a fantastic event put on by our booster club. And I'd like to announce the students that were announced that evening and ask them to come out to receive their checks. The first one we're going to talk about is the Roger M. Martell Memorial Scholarship Award. This is a $500 scholarship that was created by the Martell family to honor the memory of Roger M. Martell, a 1987 graduate of the Hampton Bays School District, whose life qualities included hard work, perseverance, and love of life. The selection is based on varsity athletic participation, desire to pursue a college education, and submission of an essay describing one's ability to overcome adversity in life. This year, the award goes to Kate Benoblock and Miles LaValle. Doc Fowler family. Doc Fowler was a former doctor of Hampton Bay School District and was very involved with the school itself, wrestling across the county. There was a wrestling tournament named after him, and also Suffolk County names there, Section Y tournament, the Doc Fowler Wrestling Tournament. And the following requirements exist for this award. This award is given to a graduating senior who has demonstrated sportsmanship, dedication, hard work and teamwork on the athletic field and in the classroom while competing in at least two sports. This perseverance and positive role model helps to make the people around them better. And this award went to Sammy Krantz and Mike Lloyd. And this is $2,500. The next three awards are three awards given out by the Booster Club. They give out six $500 scholarship awards. First one is the Bayman Pride Award. This award is given to a graduating senior who has demonstrated the characteristics of perseverance and determination both on the sports field and in the classroom while competing in these two sports. This award goes to Rich Pecoraro and Krista Robbins. Next award is the Scholar Athlete Award. This prestigious award is presented to a young woman and a young man who have attained a high cumulative grade point average during their 4 years at Hampton Bays. These students must participate in these two sports and have received postseason honors in sports in which they participated in. This award went to Luis Garcia and Courtney Dabrowski. They've also represented the school and the community in the highest fashion. This award goes to Nick Lynch and to Jenna Hogarth.
Did so much for high school athletics in Hampton Bays and throughout Long Island.
This year, the award goes to Serena Booth.
President's Awards for Educational Excellence and Academic Achievement. The purpose of this award is to recognize and reward educational excellence and to encourage students to aspire to the highest educational standards possible. Students are to earn a grade point average of 90 to 100 and achieve an 85th percentile or higher on the SAT, ACT, or other college entrance examinations. Students, please come forward as I call your name. Audience, please hold your applause until I call out all of the names. Stephanie Carlin, Brianne Frame, James Fuchs, Nelson Garrow, Laura Jimenez, Mallory Kuklinski, Andres Lindano, Jameson Metz, Brandon Quinn, Danielle Rouge, Brandon Allen, Sarah George, Kate Van Abwak, Samantha Krantz, Lance Lydell, and Jesse Rosenberg. One last round of applause for the students. Yes, I'm supposed to just check back one more time about the John and Esther O'Keefe Scholarship Award. Is Gail Dawson in the order for it? The last award this evening is the Principal's Award. And this is an award that I gave for the first time when I arrived in Hampton Bays last year. And that I'd like to give again this year. And I'm going to give it to an exceptional young lady who is a musician and a writer and someone who I sincerely hope I'm never on the receiving end of one of her editorials. And this award this year will go to Stephanie Carlin. Senior class advisors, Ms. Sarah Holden and Ms. Tara Deeks, to make some closing remarks.
by the numerous awards received tonight, the class of 2008 is an outstanding group. You are wonderful musicians, athletes, students, hallway decorators, actors, relay racers, and lip syncers.
But above all, we really think you are simply good people. You have truly impressed us and left your mark on your ways. We wish you luck in all you do. We are proud of you. We say goodnight and thank you for coming.
We've heard this before, but before we leave this evening, I just want to say one more time, I am exceptionally proud of the young men and women on the stage this evening. Congratulations, and I look forward to seeing you all tomorrow morning at commencement. Congratulations, and thank you.